What is a multivariable calculus function? F of, what should I say for the inputs? How about two variables instead of one? X, and should I use Y? Sure, why not? Well, if X and Y are independent variables, what's the dependent variable? Just choose a different letter. How about Z? So Z equals F of XY is a multivariable calculus function, meaning I've got more than one independent variable. This function takes two numbers as output input and gives you one number as output. Though the two numbers that are input are thought of as one point, the point XY. So it's still a single thing effectively going into the function, but it's got two coordinates. But you get a single number out. What's an example here? How about a simple example, x squared plus y squared? That's a function, a formula, telling you how to find z if you know two numbers, x and y. So for example, if x is 2 and y is 3, what is z? It's what I get when I replace x with 2 and I replace y with 3. 4 plus 9 is 13. If x is 2 and y is 3, z is 13. If x is negative 4 and y is 1, I get negative 4 squared plus 1 squared is 16 plus 1 is 17. In fact, if I'm only allowing myself to plug in real numbers here, I'm never going to get a negative number out, will I? X squared plus y squared will always be greater than or equal to 0. Though it does equal 0 when x is 0 and y is 0. But it's never going to get less than 0. This is going to be, I guess, a minimum value of this function. The output z is minimized at 0 when the input is the point 0, 0. And when I say point, I really do mean point as in a plane. That would be the origin of some plane. Is it possible to graph a function like this? Yes, it is. But when you graph it, you have to graph it as if you're making a three-dimensional drawing. People taking drawing in here in the past? They don't teach enough art these days. You know, I'm a mathematician, I'm STEM, but I actually was into art when I was young. Doesn't mean I'm good at it, but I was into it when I was like in seventh grade or so, drawing and painting classes. You want to imagine a three-dimensional coordinate system with three axes that, well, on the literal paper, these axes are not literally at right angles to each other. But in your mind's eye, in your imagination, you imagine they are at right angles to each other. With perspective, here's an x-axis kind of coming out of the screen at you. Imagine that's coming towards you. Here's a y-axis going to the right and maybe a little bit out of the screen. And here's a third z-axis that's going straight up in the plane of the screen. Maybe for a little extra bit of artistic flair, maybe you want to draw the xy plane itself, kind of like this. Give it a little bit more of a 3D feel. I haven't graphed the function yet. This is just the x, y, z coordinate space instead of plane. For any given point in the x, y plane, like the point 2, 3, x is 2, y is 3, this point right there, the output of the function is 13. Go up to z equals 13, pretend that's right there. Imagine it, this point is in front of the screen. That point has three-dimensional coordinates, 2, 3, 13, and it would be on the graph of the function here because it is the output of the function. The third coordinate is the output when the inputs are 2 and 3. Now imagine doing that for every point in the plane. What in the world are you going to get? I hope it makes at least a tiny bit of intuitive sense, thinking more about the formula rather than thinking about these numbers, that you would get kind of a bowl shape. And this point is on the bowl shape. The bowl shape goes up forever and ever. It's not a finite bowl. Goes up forever and ever. Kind of like a three-dimensional parabola or something. In fact, it's called a paraboloid. It is a three-dimensional version of a parabola called a paraboloid. I'm serious. How's Mathematica doing plotting this? Mathematica. Well, first, can we enter this function? How about f of x underscore y underscore equals x squared plus y squared? Will this evaluate f of 2, 3, for example? Yes. Can Mathematica make a plot? Yep, with plot 3D. Square brackets inside, put the function name without underscores, right? Only use the underscores when you first define the function. Comma, x goes between, say, negative 5 and 5, and y goes between negative 5 and 5. Just expanding on the syntax of the plot command. What will we see? Huh. Doesn't look exactly like a bowl shape, does it? Well, that's because the domain that we're plotting this over is a square rather than a circle. I always forget how this syntax goes, so I always have to look it up. If I add a function in here, comma, region, let's see, region plot? Okay, I have to look it up. I go to the documentation center, under the help menu, I look up plot 3D. I always forget how this syntax goes, so I look for examples. It's, and you go scroll down a bit, it's this kind of weird syntax. Region function, that's kind of weird. This is representing a disk in the plane, x squared plus y squared is less than or equal to 4. I'm just going to highlight this whole thing here and copy and paste it into my document right here after a comma. And then since I want to maybe do the disk of radius 5, I should put 5 squared or 25 there. So now it's going to plot it over a disk of radius 5 instead of a square. And now it looks more like a bowl. Because I mean, ignoring inputs that are outside a disk. A disk is a circle and the inside of the circle. Everything outside of that disk of radius 5, I'm ignoring for inputs. And so that's why now it looks more like a bowl. Hang on, 5 more minutes or so. Now, use your imagination. Imagine taking a knife. My hand is a knife. Slice that with horizontal slices. What will you get? You'll get circles. What do those circles look like? Well, they're centered at the origin. There are circles of various radii. Higher radius, the higher the slice is, because that's where the circle was wider. If instead of plot 3D, I do a contour plot, f of x, y, it graphs those circles. This is another way to visualize the function that can actually be put on paper more easily, you might say. These circles, you want to imagine, are circles you get from slicing that three-dimensional function with different heights for your slices. And if you scroll the mouse over these, it's a little hard to see here, but like when you touch this one, there we go. That's hard to see, but that says 5 is what that number says. And then I go down here and it says, oh, it's hard to see right on top of the cursor. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. What are those numbers? Those are the heights of the slice. That's what they are. This is like looking at a map of a mountain, or in this case, a valley. And those numbers are telling you your elevation on the three-dimensional graph. It's called a contour map. And in Mathematica, you use contour plot to make it. And these curves are called level curves. And for this function, they are circles. Last thing I'll say today, this is going to come up in a big way on Wednesday. Our main topic Wednesday is called implicit differentiation. It's section 3.7. It is in the book. Multivariable calculus and these level curves are going to be our main application of implicit differentiation. We can use implicit differentiation to study the level curves of multivariable calculus functions that we really couldn't study any other way if we didn't have technology, at least. Okay? All right. Have a good day.